Hey, everybody. Welcome back to the hottest hip-hop show across the country right here on World Street Hip-Hop. I'm your man, world famous DJ Dunn B. Man, I'm going to say a big shout-out to everybody been supporting World Street Hip-Hop, man. I love you guys. And we've been talking about him since 7 o'clock tonight, and it's 9 o'clock. We got him on the show with us tonight for the first time. We got Mr. Michael Cooper, who is running for lieutenant governor, man. Welcome to the show. Well, how you doing on this beautiful Wednesday night? Hump Day Wednesday, man. What's going on,
hump
man?
Hump Day Wednesday. Just trying to get through Hump Day, dog. We're getting the boat out. We need to get everybody out the boat right now, Dunn.
Yeah, that is so true, man, because yesterday was the first day of early voting. Now, I want to remind everybody, early voting only going to be for 2 weeks, for 10 days. So after early voting, the election will be March the 6th?
March the 6th, from 8 to 7, and I tell you what, you need to get out the early voting. Get to the polls before they close.
Yes.
The polls close at 7 and 6. Some of them closing at 5 o'clock, like yesterday. We had to push ours up. 4:30, we all met, and we all went in there and made that historical vote. Like you said,
right.
Why are you so excited about being the first African American lieutenant governor of state? I said, because I'm the first person that's inclusive and not exclusive. I want to include everybody.
So you already, let's talk about that, Mr. Cooper. You already made history as of now as the first African American to be even on the ballot to run. Let's talk about that.
Well, from what I understand, there was one other guy from Baylor, my daughter's student at Baylor, and he's an ex-football player. I think he was on the ballot to run, but he did not make it to the primaries and did not make it as lieutenant governor. So we want to create history, make history. And a lot of people, some people get upset about that, but they don't understand that. We're talking about 2018, 21st century, and we're still talking about the first black this, the first black that, first one this, first one that.
Mm-hmm.
We need the best candidate. I just happen to be black. You know, that's what
right.
I'm telling everybody. I say, so I am a viable candidate. You know, I'm an office executive. I'm a psychologist. Got my master's in psychology. I'm a pastor. I'm an entrepreneur.
You everything.
I'm a mentor. Yeah, I'm a whole bunch. I sleep 3.5 hours a day, Donna, just like you.
Right. Let's talk about this, man, because this you're right. This is going to be the most important election, especially for the state of Texas. I'm always telling young people all the time that your local and statewide election is just as important as your nationwide election. Let's talk about that, because I want the young people from 18 and up that tunes into my show, I want them to get a really, really good understanding. Let's talk about that.
Well, I'll tell you what, Donna, lieutenant governor is number 2 position in state Texas, number 1 in power. That's the reason why I decided to go after it. It doesn't pay the most money, but it has the most power. He is the president of the Senate. He has the deciding vote whenever there's a tie about things that's going on with health care and education. And he can push bills through to become law. So he's very important. So why would people be concerned about the state? Well, if you're concerned with things going on in your neighborhood, in your backyard, well, the city level can only do what the state tells them to do. So you have to reach up higher to make changes locally. I have a friend of mine that's a representative, Joe Desitelli. He said, I try to make a difference in education. He said, but I'm only one vote. So I decided to become his boss through the legislation system and say, hey, I'm going to help him out make the right votes, make the right decisions. He needs support. Mm-hmm. We need to back one another in our electoral events.
Let's talk about this too, Mr. Cooper. That's why I love doing an interview by myself when I'm doing an interview. Most times when I'm doing my interview, I'm doing it with 2 or 3 different people, and I really can't get a lot out like I want to. I want to talk about this. This has been a crazy month. We had a school shooting. Yeah, what are your thoughts on that? And also, what plan do you have to try to prevent more school shooting? Because this is really sad when you got 18 school shootings in 2018. Something needs to be done about that.
Yeah, a lot can be done about it. The problem is that a lot of people are not talking about education. That's the reason why I have a problem with Dan Patrick. He's a lieutenant governor now. And he was talking about bathroom bills and things like that. We need to talk about the classroom. And we need to talk about educating our kids and stop worrying about standardized testing and start talking about everyday testing and find out where the kids are reading right now. And teaching in cursive writing. A lot of people say, well, you care about in cursive writing. Well, you can't sign your signature without in cursive writing. Our great-grandparents, they just wrote an X down there, and that's what they want us to go back to. All people perish for lack of knowledge, and if we don't get knowledge in everyday school, and we're going to be in trouble. We have to protect our schools And what you get is by having one way in, one way out, fences up. Somebody said, well, that's like a prison. I said, well, if you don't take care of them now when they're in school, they're going to end up in prison. So that's the reason why I want to look at that. And the other thing is that I want to make sure that whenever someone graduates from ninth grade to 12th grade, that we send the information to the NRA and a program to where we can look at their conduct. Because that young man that did that shooting was kicked out of school, did in school suspension. They couldn't handle him anymore, and he was mad and bitter at the system. So somebody needs to be tracking that information, and I want to track that with the NRA and our society so we won't be selling guns to people that are mentally ill. This kid is mentally ill.
Right. Do you think also that the FBI could have done a better job in investigating it?
The FBI
his Facebook page.
They had information there. A lot of people said that they don't like Big Brother. They don't want people peeping into their pages. We need to have red flags that we need to make Facebook responsible also. They have flags for other things else. They need to have flags for people that are having derogatory statements and remarks. That's either depressed or suicidal. We need to look at those things and not go into people's privacies, but we need to take care of the public. And right now, those 17 kids were gunned down innocently. They did nothing wrong except to go out and try to get an education. So we need to stop bump stock sales of guns, AR-57s. Mm-hmm. We don't need those guns or high-power rifles. And I'm going to do everything I can in my power in the state of Texas to fix those laws, change those laws. But we have to fight and rebuke a Republican Senate. We have to fight them.
Let me ask you this, because I was a campus monitor for the school, and I did work at an elementary school. To me, I think it's very important also, if you look at every state, every city, they have metal detectors in every place. Why come we can't spend the money? Trump made a statement some weeks back, and he said that he was going to take 3